As interest in the metaverse grows, so too are the number of tools and platforms to help develop it. Here are the top resources for metaverse developers. If you want to build applications or services for the metaverse, you won't have to start from scratch. As the metaverse continues to gain attention across a variety of sectors, a number of tools and platforms are appearing to help coders develop for the metaverse. Here we take a look at 7 such metaverse development tools and frameworks. Our picks also all happen to be open source, which will make them attractive for programmers who want to avoid being locked into the metaverse development tools of major businesses or proprietary platforms. While it's too early in the history of the metaverse to say for sure which projects will dominate the open source metaverse development scene, the tools and frameworks detailed here are strong contenders for becoming key resources for metaverse developers. If you're a metaverse developer who likes open source, you'll love Webiverse. The stated mission of the platform is to shift the power from a few big tech companies to users and creators in the context of metaverse development. Webiverse aims to do that by offering a fully open source, customizable metaverse engine that anyone can use as the foundation for building their own metaverse. You can host it wherever you want. The only requirement is having Node.js 17 or later available. Hypercube. For metaverse developers inclined toward creating a decentralized metaverse platform, rather than one they host themselves, Hypercube is a project worth looking at. It's a blockchain whose intended use cases include powering the so-called Hyperverse, an extended reality environment that you could consider a form of metaverse. The project seems not yet fully mature, but it merits consideration for coders who seek integration between metaverse apps and the blockchain ecosystem. X-Rengine. X-Rengine is an ambitious project that aims to make metaverse development as easy and natural as making a website. To do that, the project bundles a variety of open-source tools to create a metaverse development framework that provides tooling for 3D world creation, voice and video-based communication, user management, and much more. As of mid-2022, X-Rengine is probably the most important open-source development framework to know. JanusWeb. JanusWeb is another open-source, developer-friendly metaverse programming framework. It focuses on creating 3D environments that run in web browsers, with rendering powered by 3.js or WebGL. Because JanusWeb focuses on 3D world creation, its scope is currently more limited than that of X-Rengine, which aims to be more of a general-purpose metaverse platform for developers. Still, if creating 3D worlds is your main goal, JanusWeb is a good place to start. WebXR Device API. Giving web apps direct access to hardware devices is critical for many metaverse development use cases. The WebXR Device API is designed to simplify that process by giving developers a standardized API that they can use to access virtual reality and augmented reality hardware from within web apps. Open Metaverse Interoperability Group. To keep up to date with metaverse-friendly APIs and other resources in general, follow the Open Metaverse Interoperability Group, or OMI, whose mission is to collaborate on creating open standards for ensuring that metaverse development is open and that metaverse apps, services, and platforms can easily integrate with one another. Blender. Blender, the open-source 3D modeling platform, came into being long before anyone was talking about the metaverse. But it remains the open-source ecosystem's go-to solution for creating and manipulating 3D visualizations, which makes it a key platform to know for developers working on 3D metaverse apps. Big tech names join new group to make metaverse interoperable. A new nonprofit group is coordinating efforts to build an open metaverse and already counts more than 1,000 companies and organizations as members, including big tech names such as Meta, Microsoft, and NVIDIA. The Metaverse Standards Forum will try to figure out how to make the metaverse work for the myriad companies and their technologies. Free to join, the forum is hosted by the Kronos Group, a nonprofit standards consortium. On August 10, the forum will hold its first full-day workshop at the SIGGRAPA 2022 conference in Vancouver. One of the guest speakers will be Neil Stephenson, author of Snow Crash, where he coined the term metaverse. We have one internet. We like to have one metaverse, and we are going to have to build it together, said Mark Petit, vice president of the Unreal Engine ecosystem at Epic Games, in a podcast about the forum. The forum will focus on pragmatic, action-based projects to accelerate testing and adoption of metaverse standards, as well as develop consistent terminology and deployment guidelines. The virtual world of the metaverse needs new ways of integrating diverse technologies for collective spatial computing, taking current technologies, including 3D graphics, AR, VR, digital twins, multi-user gaming, and others, and lifting them to new levels of scale and immersion. The group believes that the metaverse's potential is best realized if it is built on an open standards foundation. Other notable members include Adobe, Autodesk, Deloitte, Epic Games, Huawei, IKEA, HTC, Intel, Lenovo, LG, Pandora, POC, Qualcomm, Verizon, ZTE, Samsung, AMD, Panasonic, Haier, Red Hat, T-Mobile, and Vodafone. Metaverse value chain and components. The metaverse can be best understood as the next generation of the internet. It will build upon and iteratively transform it. It requires extraordinary technical advancements, producing shared persistent simulations that millions of users synchronized in real time, and will involve a robust regulatory framework, business policies, and change in consumer behavior. Here, I have created a framework to make sense of the stack that needs to come together and organize to establish flow and enable the metaverse. Information on each of these building blocks is scattered and hard to entirely imagine a concrete end state of. I hope to use this framework as a reference point when tracking emergence of new technologies, activity of big tech and gaming companies, as well as track startups. Given that the metaverse itself is not a monolith, but is ever-evolving and dynamic due to its several moving pieces, this framework will also continue to evolve. For a user, all of the potential use cases lie within the user experience bucket. This is the layer encompassing creating and consuming content, games, attending live events, work, collaboration, and other enterprise applications. This is also where marketplaces will come into being in a big way, where users will be trading assets. All of these experiences will be underpinned by digital payments and financial services and hold tremendous potential for blockchain, cryptocurrencies, and decentralized finance applications that are emerging today. The interface to the metaverse for the user will be provided through the hardware building block, from evolving smartphones, VR/AR, haptic to display technology. At the center sits the mammoth virtualization engine, in simplified terms, the processor of the metaverse. A tremendously high degree of computing power combining cloud, edge, local, and blockchain computing will all have to come together to provide computing power. Programming engines will allow for developers to create applications for the metaverse. This layer also holds virtual platforms, providing ecosystems of developers and content creators. Avatars and asset creators will enable virtualization of human identity and generate virtual assets. All of this will rest on the base, either network and hardware development from 5G to 6G, and evolutions in chips, tiny sensors, and light technology. All these building blocks will be guided by tools, protocols, formats, services, and engines, which serve as standards for interoperability and enable the creation, operation, and ongoing improvements to the metaverse. What do you think about our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button. Also, subscribe to our channel before you go.